Welcome back to Empires of the Undergrowth. So, what I love about this game is, A, it's the only game where I get to build an ant empire. And two, they update it like every month. So this month, they're introducing a new extra level, and it's called the Other Foot. And it's a totally different take on what we've been doing before. Do you remember back when we had like the Formicarium, aka it's like an aquarium for ants, is the easiest way to say what a Formicarium is. But when we were doing the Formicarium challenges, the evil man scientist was like sending in ants invading us and then different bugs. Well, did you ever wonder where those other ants were coming from? Yeah, we're that colony. That's the Other Foot. So ultimately what we have to do is build up an ant colony, but we get to try out the new army ants. Also the trap jaws and the slave makers. So there are three ants. Species, I guess, that we don't normally get to play with. We're gonna have to battle big bugs, including the biggest, most giant spider that ever was.
It ever will be.
And then also, the ultimate goal is to destroy our old Formicarium. All right, so pretty humble origins here. We've got a bunch of little bit of food, and we're gonna have to dig this out to get to the overworld. And I think this little pot is where we're gonna put our food. Now, we're gonna do something that I haven't really done in Empires of the Undergrowth before, and that's try to build, like, an actual ant mound under the ground, right? Like, inform it in a way that ants actually would. So in order to do that, we're gonna have to make, well, more ants. This is an ant empire, after all. Now, one of the reasons I'm gonna do a more pod approach, a more pod-like approach, is because it's easier to upgrade. And we'll get into that a little bit later. All right, so now it is time to go into the undergrowth. Our ant empire of blue beauties. They're beautiful right now, but they're gonna look a little bit more dangerous when they're biting and eating everything that we gotta do. But there we go. We've made it into the undergrowth, and it looks like you see all these little numbers? Yep, that's food. We's gonna get it. So the food does help us grow, but I feel like he's got devious purposes. The preview made it seem like I'm gonna have to provide our ants as food for these diabolical science experiments. We are the test subjects. Well, I'm technically a dude disguised as a dude playing a queen ant. So, I mean, I won't have to give myself for ire, but everybody else,
I think
yeah.
It is time we connected the outworld to the feeder colonies. I want to see how these eruptors respond under pressure.
Oh. I will prepare the experiment.
Okay. They're preparing, quote, the experiment, which I don't know about that, man. It doesn't sound too good, does it?
Continue the experiment and let me know the results.
Continue the experiment. Prepare the tea. Defend the colonies. Sorry. It's just, you know, British. It triggers us. I usually throw tea in the harbor. But anyway, this is the upgrade system. Basically, you see, there's these little plus one. It kind of reminds me of the game Civilization. Who here has ever played Civilization? The food stores are full. Oh.
I wonder how they will react to a rival eruptor colony.
Oh, shoot.
Introducing 40 rival eruptors.
Get workers to the tube? 40? I need to provide 40 ants as food for their nasty little plans. And there is just an absolute buttload.
It's a gold mine of food.
Oh, you poor silly ants. You're all going to die. Look at how much food I can store at 600 in this small area. This is the key to upgrading, which is something I've never really done too much with. So we'll upgrade them even more to see how much we can hold. And while that's happening, we need to expand. Let's see, 24, so if my math is correct, since I didn't do any, that might be enough. It also might not. Haha, there it is. Okay, so we're gonna have 40 ants. We're gonna send them right into the tubes. And then after that, I'm presuming that they're gonna give us new ant types, as well as more challenges within our own Formicarium. So now that we have 27 out of 40, what seems to be the issue? Oh, we don't have enough food. That might be a little bit of a problem. Did I get a little bit too ambitious with this? Yeah, we have 36 out of 40. I think I'll have to use both control groups. Actually, control group one will kind of stay in reserve. Control group two, which is 36 out of the 40. So we'll only have 8 plus 7, 15 ants left. All right, everybody. I'm sending you to a happy place. I promise you're giving your life for the good of the colony. And you're the last one. Good luck, Charles. Oh, they pulled the straw. Okay. Army ants have been unlocked. This is excellent. And they dropped some more food. So we got a little bit of food, but look at this. Army ants is in the new patch. You're going to be able to build bridges with these things over water. So yeah, while all of my ants died, that man calls it science. But the good news is we're going to be able to rebuild our entire force, and we're going to have 40 worker ants. My goodness.
What about a combination of Arepta and Fusca? Let's start with 20.
Oh gosh, we got the little spiders, these little whip spiders. We're definitely going to want to build up some army ants. All right, so this is where we're going to put the army ants. Look at how much food we have. Dig that tunnel. Control group one, you're going over there. Look at that, man. This thing is just... We're cooking with gas. Army ants are small. They're definitely smaller than our traditional worker ants, but they cost 40. The Eciton Bocelli. Sounds like a dude who sings opera. All right, Eciton Bocelli. I'll have the cacio e pepe as mi primi, and mi secondi chocolate-covered ants, or spiders, I guess, since we're eating them. All right, so that was the first one. So this one is only, I guess, 20 more? Now they're probably gonna tell me what. Oh, there we go. Okay, everybody back. Retreat!
How will they handle a sustained flow of aggressors?
A sustained flow of aggressors. Okay, so we gotta keep the tubes supplied with workers. Do I have the food? Yeah, I definitely should have the food stores. Oh my gosh, and they just drop roly-polies. And even more food.
My raptors. Perhaps a small reward. Look to the surface.
I love the character of the mad scientist because he like imagine of all the types of mad scientists you have out there, who's the mad scientist that works with ants? You know what I mean? Like, oh yes, I'm working on a nuclear ballistic missile. What are you doing, Ivan? Oh, da, tovarish. Ivan milk igloo that is made of fire. And then like, oh, what about you, Stanley? What are you up to in the mad scientist realm? I'm feeding ants to other ants. And he's just like the weirdest mad scientist of them all. Oh gosh. Okay, we got a situation out here. They drop combatants into our arena. Oh gosh, that's a big one. Send in the army ants. All right, so, whoa, are the army ants growing? It kind of looked like they were. Ooh, a mother load. Ooh, slave makers have been unlocked. All right, this is where we're gonna put the indentured servitude makers over here. All right, I've never had this much food, I think, maybe like in any of these games. And this will be the indentured servitude makers. Wonder how much food that's gonna cost us. Holy crap, I just 60, goodness gracious. Whoa, oh, they're dropping enemy worker ants, it looks like. That's not gonna be a threat to our fire ants. Okay, now they're dropping fire ants down here. Oh, no, these are the woodcutter ants because they can fire like an acidic spit out of their butts, which is just a terrifying thought when you really, really think about that. Survive the incoming attacks. That's not gonna be a problem, hopefully. He says with false bravado. Oh gosh, attack! Dude, my workers are destroying him. I don't care how big you are. When you have to fight like 100 of us, we're gonna, you may kill a bunch of us, but we'll eventually get you. I guess in some ways it does pay to be a science experiment because I have a massive army with relatively small obstacles. I can upgrade at my heart's content. The adjacency bonuses are there. Oh wow, I can upgrade these. I'm rich. We got the tiger beetles. The tigers. Get the Panzerfaust hands. This is probably gonna be a 2-3 part series right here on this level alone. This is a rather sizable extra level that just came in their June update. And then they've got a big one coming with the army ants update. Like, I'm very excited for that because the idea of being able to build an army ant bridge is pretty dang cool. Oh gosh, now we got wolf spiders. Get them. I'm not entirely sure what the indentured servitude drivers do. Like, what? That wolf spider just like regenerated its health. You, sir, are a hacker. That is illegal.
Perhaps it is time we began phase two of the trial.
Uh-oh.
Agreed.
What was that?
Prepare the feeder colonies.
Oh man, we're a feeder colony again.
Our raptors will need to put up a strong defense, adding 20 roof ants.
Oh man, what's a roofah ant? Do I have to supply the roofahs? Oh, trap jaw ants have been unlocked. Okay, so trap jaw ants are some of the best soldiers, which is indicative in their price. Look at that, 90 food. Compare that to the 40 for an army ant, the 20 for a worker, and then the 65 for the slave makers. A full line of trap jaws, please. Look at, and all the while that other ant colony, the one we used to control, is being decimated. Oh, there they are. Oh, goodness. And they're on the skull, too. Look at these things. Send in the army. Call in the National Guard. Call in everything. We need the A-10 warthogs. That'd be like if you could combine like the Green Army Men game with this game, you'd have like, I don't know, man. It'd be weird. Okay, well, that was easy, right? We just defeated the giant ants. Look at that. That is the husk of the giant ant we had to defeat. But we have the most powerful army we've ever had. Yeah, if you guys could get back to work, that'd be cool. But yeah, I really think this might be the biggest colony I've ever made. It's definitely up there in the top two or three.
I wonder how long okay. will survive
well, that's
against
gonna
the
sustained growth
of all three colonies. Let's see.
All right, so we're going to have to send them while the grasshoppers are attacking. This reminds me of A Bug's Life. So way back in the day, man, there was like that animated Bugs movie called A Bug's Life. But there was also an animated movie called Ants. And it was a little more adult themed, and it had like Sylvester Stallone as like one of the main ants. And he was like this big, bad, like army ant, you know? And I liked that one a little more because it was all about the ants going to like this epic war against the termites. And the termites were like these big, nasty creatures. It was awesome. And I remember being young and being like, dude, that should be a video game.
What's this?
Oh my gosh.
1, 2, 3, 9, 10 wolf spiders.
Yeah, it maybe stop that, you madman. Why couldn't you have been a mad scientist who tried to build igloos out of fire or something? Oh. Incoming attack. Those don't look like the red fire ants. It's the fire nation of ants versus, I guess we're the... Is it the water the wind nomads, right? I need to watch. I need to get up on my pop culture here. Food stores are full. Where do you want me to put all this food there, bucko? I mean, I shouldn't be complaining. If you look closely on the food tiles, you're gonna see like little grasshopper arms, little bits of tiger beetles, probably some wolf spiders if you look closely. It looks like coffee beans of some kind, but like seeds. Really weird looking ones, these blue ones. Survive the incoming attacks, okay.
Be careful, my queen.
Whoa!
I'm not finished
with you yet. Whoa, invasion! Everybody to the depths! They've got a cave troll! There's a dungeon! Oh wait, there's a troll in the dungeon! That's where they always come from, man. Lord of the Rings, Harry Potter, and Empires of the Undergrowth. Defend your queen, you idiots! Dude, that was amazing. We just got blitzkrieged down here.
It's like the mole people invaded.
That was actually sneaky. All right, there we go. Now we know. We need the Praetorian Guards. They're going to be an elite squad of trapjaw ants that are just guarding the queen because I think she took a few bites. There we go. Oh my gosh, we're basically out of food. Whoa. You're not allowed down here. Okay, that's quite terrifying. Daddy Longlegs just like invaded. I didn't know that was possible. Army ants, engage. Wow, we lost a lot. An entire division, an entire legion of my best ants died. I need Sylvester Stallone the ant to lead me into battle. All right, so this is, you're gonna be control group 5, and 5 protects the queen. You will guard her. And you know what, we're gonna, if we can afford it, which we can't right now, we're actually almost out of money. I was gonna say, we're gonna upgrade them to tier 3. Oh, snap! All right, well, we've got the Praetorian Guard defending the queen down here. We've defended against multiple waves. There's going to be more, but this one's going to be a multi-part episode. If you guys want to see more Surviving the Undergrowth, let me know. Pull the trigger on that like button, and I'll see you guys in the next part. Thanks for watching.